Welcome to Fact TV. I'm Sierra.
And I'm Brooklyn, and today is Thursday, March 10th, and today is also National Bagpipe Day.
Did you know in some places you could hear a bagpipe from 10 miles away?
Wow, that's pretty interesting. And ladies, MORP is March 26th, and the theme is decades. Start getting your dates and planning how you're going to dress.
Mr. Fremont started off great this week, and our candidates have been gracious competitors. Let's take a quick peek on what has happened so far. I was raised by the wolves. I was raised by the wolves. I was raised by the wolves. 8 to 4. Run through the night.
They finish up the competition today with their cake decorating skills. All Mr. Fremont candidates should meet in the Commons today right after PAC TV. Then tomorrow at 8 a.m. will be the Mr. Fremont Assembly. Good luck, gentlemen.
Anyone interested in running for student government for next year, there is a mandatory meeting next Tuesday, the 15th at 7 a.m. in Tori Pollard's room.
And the Paw Print staff just passed out their latest issue during Flex. And there's some pretty good articles, so make sure you grab one before you leave Flex class.
And with that, the talk around town is the war in Ukraine and the rising gas prices. So Colton went and asked students about teachers about this.
We're here with Wyatt. Wyatt, how do you feel about today's gas prices?
It's just a crap show. That's what it is. Sir.
Good sir. How do you feel about today's gas prices?
Gas prices are too high.
Too high? Mm-hmm. I agree. How do you feel about today's gas prices?
They're bad.
They're bad? How so?
I can't afford it.
Understandable. Where do you work at?
Walk West.
That's really understandable then. We are here with our soccer coach, Mr. Smith. Mr. Fred Smith, to be exact. Smith, how do you feel about today's gas prices?
Sucks.
Do you have a very fuel-efficient car?
I do have one. I have a couple, actually.
Oh, what is the car that you drive here?
Making my way downtown, walking fast, faces pass and I'm homebound.
And the art show ends tomorrow, and there's lots of great work being displayed upstairs in the lecture hall, so go check it out.
The librarians in the English department are pleased to present Utah's very own Newbery Honor-winning author Christian Heidecker on March 25th. He will be doing a book signing, and those speaking to those who wish to learn more on writing developing stories, talk with your English teacher or the librarians about this cool event.
And FBLA just competed at their state competition yesterday. There were 15 students that competed, so congrats to Cheyenne Hoffman for taking fourth in her competition.
And this goes out to all NHS members. They are having a field trip on Monday, March 21st. They will be visiting BYU and four museums. If you are a member and want to be a part of this, then pay $5 to the bookkeeper and bring your receipt to Remy. This needs to be paid by next Thursday.
And ProStart will be having a food truck Friday on March 25th. There'll be desserts, lunch, you name it. And they might have it. More information will come.
And with that, let's go to Darren in the locker room with sports.
Thanks, and it's sports! Spring sports were supposed to begin this week, and it had a rough start with the weather. Basically, weather one, sport zero. However, the weather is getting a little better, and some of the teams have some games this weekend. Let's begin with boys soccer. They are heading down to St. George for a three-game tournament. They will be going up against Jordan Skyline in Pleasant Grove. Good luck, team. Then, the baseball team will also be hosting the Vikings of Pleasant Grove tomorrow afternoon. First pitch at 3:30. And just to the west of the baseball field, the lacrosse team will be hosting Northridge on the turf. Good luck to these programs as they start their seasons. And let's not forget our girls' golf team. If the weather permits, they will be teeing up. Oh, sorry. Not today. That's my bad. Sorry. Anyone interested in trying out for Silverline, remember there is a tryout meeting tonight at 5:30. And finally, in sports, cheer tryouts will be here before you know it. And next Monday, the 14th, will be a meeting at 6 p.m. in the lecture hall to talk to you about these upcoming tryouts and the clinics that happen right before. If you have any questions, see a cheerleader or Coach Schofield. And that's it for sports. Back to you two.
Thanks, seniors. The Counseling Center wants you to stop by and pick up the Moyes Scholarship application. The deadline for this is Friday, so don't delay.
And it's that time of year again. It happens this time every year. This Sunday, daylight savings time begins. So move your clocks forward an hour. Sad. We lose an hour of sleep.
And now it's time for Fremont's Hottest Cars.
All right, guys, this is the third episode of Fremont's Hottest Cars, and I've been told that I'm taking too long, so I'm going to go through all these cars really fast. All right, let's just start off with this one right here. It's a really nice-looking WRX. Next, we got this Silverado, and then another. I think this is another WRX, I think. It looks pretty sick, but yeah. We got this single-cab Silverado back here. It looks really nice. I like those wheels. We got this older generation F-150. It looks pretty nice. And yeah, and then we got this really old car. It looks really nice. Like, I haven't seen a car like that old that nice before. So yeah, I would love to drive that car. And our last car is this car. I think that it's a Ferrari. Yeah, it's either a Ferrari or a Lamborghini. I don't know, one of those two. But yeah, that's all the cars we have.
That's it for PAC TV. Have a great day, Wolves.